I must admit, I have given myself a little bit of a challenge to go through the two main lineages which currently circulate due to the A virus that currently circulate in the Middle East and in Africa. But I will do my best to take you through the journey of these two lineages. And before I really start, I would like to give you a little bit of background to the methodology that we have used for the research, and I give you the example of the, I give you the background based on the example of a recent paper to which many of you have contributed, and thank you for your contribution. So in that paper, we have shown that when phylogenies are built within the capsid coding region, the resulting trees are very concise in terms of dating and phylogeny. So therefore, this region is really good for tracing and dating dating events. However, when the phylogenies are being built outside of the capsid coding region, they're a little bit more dispersed. Actually, they're far more dispersed. And then they're represented, so each individual phylogeny is represented by the dot here. So therefore, really when we want to trace an outbreak, we often use the VP1 coding region for identifying the serotype and the subtypes within the serotype. And this is really the right approach. And based on this approach, we then can define the ecological pools of foot and mouth disease circulation, and then we can trace how the virus moves between the pools and when it escapes. So this is a little bit of a background. But the talk today is going to concentrate on the two poles, pool 4 and pool 5, both of them in Africa, and then we're going to move on into pool 2 and pool 3 in the Middle East. So with the main focus, of course, on the A Africa G4 in Africa and then A Asia G7 in the Middle East and the Indian subcontinent. So starting with the A Africa G4, here, using the Bayesian approach, we have identified that really the virus has originated in the eastern part of the continent. And since then, it evolved into two different centers of circulation, one established in East Africa, the other in West Africa. But this is not the end of the story. Since then, we have noticed multiple events, multiple outbreaks of the East African strains up north in Egypt, while the West African lineages have, like viruses, have then outbroke in the Maghreb region. But this outbreak has been described by our Italian colleagues very recently. So. Really, there is very little we know about the circulation of the viruses in Africa. And perhaps we have placed these dots on the map just for the fact that there are few countries that submit the samples. So therefore, we would like to acknowledge these countries that and encourage others at the same time to submit the samples. This only really Cameroon and Nigeria submit samples from West Africa, and perhaps when we move forward, then we can understand better the epidemiology and the spread of the viruses. But for the moment, what we can do is really join the dots on the map. And from that, we can see that the virus travels from the east part of the continent to the west, and then respectively, the virus moves up north. However, the direct link between the west and east center of circulation has not been clearly established. But in Africa, these lineages do not exist on their own. There are other lineages that perform in similar way. And let's look at some of the other lineages that are dominant in Africa. One of them mentioned during the conference today is the O virus East Africa 3. And again, looking at the phylogeny, the Bayesian-based phylogeny, we can see both centers, then number of outbreaks in North Africa. This virus is different to East Africa, to AG7, A Africa G4, for the fact that it outbroke in Israel and Palestine, as Case has mentioned. And then we also see outbreaks in North Africa. So not very dissimilar to what we have seen with the G4 lineage. And again, joining the dots The same challenges, we do not really have much information on the lineage, but joining the dots, we can see the pattern of movement of the viruses is very similar. And let's look at another lineage, which is dominant in North Africa. And again, a very, very similar story to the story before, but no outbreak in Maghreb region yet. So what are the key lineages? What are the key points from this part of the talk? So there are three main lineages that exist in the ecological landscape of northern part of Africa. But we cannot establish the precise movement of these viruses. We know that they move from east to west, and then we know that they move up north, perhaps independently. And we also know that if one virus has arrived into Maghreb regions, other can follow, and perhaps the next one is the SAT2. Moving eastwards, we're going to focus on the AHG7 lineage now. And recently, we have published we have published a paper which looks at the outbreaks of the due to this lineage in Saudi Arabia, Armenia, Turkey, and Iran. And these events had occurred initially between 2015 and 16. And the purpose of this paper was really to look whether we could establish how many events have occurred for the outbreak, for the virus to move from the Indian subcontinent into the Middle East. And what we have established really is that based on the VP1 coding region only, it was difficult to predict. However, since there have been outbreaks in Israel, and then again the question arose, is this a new introduction, a continuation of the outbreak that has is ongoing? And again, the conclusion is similar. After performing Bayesian analysis, based on the VP1 coding sequence only, it is difficult to determine the direction and number of introduction into the regions. So inspired by a paper that had been published by Jonathan Arts group in Plum Island, who investigated full genome sequence data of lineages that circulate in Southeast Asia. He identified that there had been many instances of recombination. So we wanted to follow on, so take example from this study and perhaps look at the lineages that circulate in the Middle East. And indeed, there are very many of them, very many viruses circulating intensely in the same geographical area, as we have heard previously from the talk from Turkey. So I have gathered 259 whole genome sequences, and I have analyzed them initially, of course, looking at the VP1 coding region. And surely enough, all of them group according to serotype, topotype, and lineage. However, then we were interested to look at the furthest part of the genome away from the capsid coding region. And we were interested to see what is the dynamics of the sequences in the 3D coding region. So it won't, to many of us, it won't be a surprise that this tree is very heterogeneous and very colorful. Each of the colors represent different serotype and different lineage and sublineage within the serotype. But once one starts to annotate this tree, it clearly appears that some of the viruses cluster according to the geographical region of origin. And we've got two Middle Eastern-like clades and a clade of viruses that are mainly like the Indian subcontinent viruses. But there are two other main clades that remain. And trying to annotate them, one of them consists 3D coding regions of the old Middle East, South Asia, India 2001 D lineage, the lineage that caused pandemic outbreaks until 2015. The other, however, clusters viruses that belong to the lineage that replaced the 2001 D lineage, the India 2001 E lineage. And of course, these old viruses are accompanied by other viruses, both of them by Asia 1 viruses, and then, surprise, surprise, there come the Asia G7 data.
Four minutes.
Okay, sorry. I'm just finishing. And then the India 2001 lineage is closely related to the G7 viruses. If I can move the slide. The G7 viruses that currently circulate in the Indian subcontinent and some historic data from India. However, the sublineage is related to all the Middle Eastern G7 viruses. But those who can spot differences can see that there is another clade, quite interesting. So groups together with the Middle Eastern-like clade, but a little bit away. And this is usually a suggestion of recombination. And indeed, when these viruses are examined, it's not a surprise that really the clade is a combination of currently circulating virus. Yes, the viruses in Iran and Israel, the very recent viruses of 2016 and 17, and the lineage that had been mentioned in the Turkish talk, which viruses due to the O serotype COM15. And further on, we performed some recombination analysis by Simplot. And this is not a surprise that really in the capsid coding region, the sequences are very diverse. Of course they are. But when we look at the non-structural coding region, the profile of the lineages is very similar until we reach the second part of the 3D coding region. And this is where we see an indication of a recombination between the A Asia G7 lineage and the O Pan Asia COM15. This leads me to highlight the key points. And the key points are really that there is an evidence that there is the regions within the non-structural coding sequence are of different ancestral origin. We have evidence that the currently circulating O and the A viruses can recombine the genetic material, but we cannot establish really the direction of the exchange. But perhaps we need to look into the non-structural coding region, and perhaps this would allow us to better understand the movement of lineages and perhaps even predict the new and upcoming lineages. But before I finish, I would like to reinforce the message that Case had given at the beginning of this session, that really viruses exist in the very complex ecological niches when they can coexist and co-evolve. And really there is the continuous need for monitoring and vigilance. And with that, I would like to thank you for your attention and the partners for the support and exchange of information.